Altair is based on the Vega Lite visualization grammar. Being familiar with the elements which make up this grammar is critical in understanding what Altair is capable of visualizing. To illustrate this concept, the visualization grammar can be broken down into several components. Before we create any visualization, we need some data to visualize. Data comes in many shapes and sizes, but we will consider data that is in a tabular format. Specifically, data in which each column represents a variable and each row represents an observation or record. Data of this form is sometimes referred to as tidy data. In Altair, the data can be a CSV, JSON, or even a URL pointing to where the data lives. Once the data is established, we need to consider what we would like to visualize. Marks are the geometric objects which we draw on the screen. They represent the basic building blocks from which we create our visualizations. Altair has many geometric primitives, including line, point, area, and bar marks. The next step is to create a link between the marks and the data. Encodings are one of the most important concepts in Altair's visualization grammar. An encoding is essentially a mapping between the visual properties of a mark and the variables of the data. These visual properties, sometimes referred to as encoding channels, include X position, Y position, color, size, etc. Each of these channels can be mapped to a column in the data to establish an encoding. The mapping of visual properties to data is key in creating meaningful visualizations. Altair can also perform many transformations on the data before being visualized. New variables can be calculated, filters can be applied, and even more advanced calculations such as aggregations and folds can be performed all within the visualization specification. Not all visualizations require transformations, but they allow for specifications to do a lot more than only define encodings. To complete the visualization grammar, a few more elements must be considered. A scale is nothing more than a function. The input domain of the function are the values in our dataset, and the output range are the pixels on the screen. The scale determines where to draw the marks or what color to make them based on the encodings. Guides are useful visual aids, often visualizing a scale. For instance, the tick marks on the X and Y axis are guides for their respective scales. Similarly, a legend is also a visual aid for categorical variables. Altair creates scales and guides automatically with sensible defaults, though they can be customized if needed. These elements are the foundation of Altair's visualization grammar. It can be instructive to build up a chart piece by piece to see how these elements interact. At the bottom level, you should always examine your data and think about what you would like to be visualized. For example, we will use a dataset that contains statistics on a wide variety of cars. Note that this dataset is already in the appropriate tidy form. After the data is considered, the next requirement is to choose a mark. In this case, we will use the point mark. With that, you can create your first visualization. Granted, it's not a very useful one. Here, a single point is plotted in the same position for each observation in our dataset. Encodings allow for more interesting visualizations to be made. For instance, we can map the X channel to the miles per gallon variable. Now our data is more spread out, showing how this variable is distributed. We can further map the Y channel to the horsepower variable to create a more traditional scatter plot. The relationship between miles per gallon and horsepower is now taking shape. We can create encodings for more variables in the dataset, such as mapping the color of a point to the country of origin. Note that Altair has automatically created appropriate scales and guides. Finally, we could apply some transformations to the data if needed. Here we apply a filter that keeps only cars with less than 5 cylinders. We will stop here for now, but I hope you can see how each element of the visualization grammar is used in creating a plot. By combining these elements in interesting ways, Altair can produce an impressive number of visualizations. Altair also has an entire grammar associated with building interactive visualizations, which I have not covered. I've included links in the description to a written Altair tutorial as well as the official documentation. Grab some data, make some plots, and most importantly, have fun.